Sorry, okay. Thank you very much. I'm sorry to drag you back in, but we do need to keep moving. And I'd like to introduce you to our third speaker today, which is Mark Minnick. Mark works for a company, IS and 3D Engineering. He's a naval and mechanical engineer. And he's been working on the Artemis Racing AC-72 project. A number of the Volvo 70 projects, Groupama, Telefonica, and he's now working on some projects for Rio 2016, the C-Class 2016, and ORC 38. And there's a list of projects, and he will basically be, as it says on the screen there, innovative design methods applied to an accessible foiling catamaran. So I hand you to Mark.
Thank you. Thank you for the presentation, and good morning, everyone. So this morning we should have been two because we are two on this project, but he couldn't have come because of some other project. So I will. So that is a bit both experience. So the initial idea, what we want to achieve is to make a small flying catamaran for two adults, which will be affordable, easy, stable, and evolutive. So we want it from that a beginner can get on the boat and learn, has got a curve to learn. So, and to reach that, we start to ask our questions and everything. So how we can test all the configuration, have a quick idea where to go. So we as a question, how we could analyze and optimize quickly various configuration and solution to fit the design goal. So we think about creating our own tool to reach this goal. So on this presentation, I will focus on the design tool, and at the end, I will present the boat. So the idea of the tool is to couple like a 3D parametric model with a VPP, and they are like now both the two link each other, so they fit one each other. So modification in the 3D parametric model change the VPP and they feed each one. So it's like a tool with both inside. So the 3D parametric model, you got visualization. You can see your boat each time you modify something. You got the geometry, the weight. You have a bit of structure. You have also ergonomics. You can place the people on the model. And also we've got inside that like a database we are feeding with profile and everything. So and in the VPP, there you have the internal model, the condition, target, optimization, geometry, and the outputs for sure, speed, stability, leeway, pitch. So that is the main concept of what we put together. So I wanted to show you a quick example. I hope it won't be too long. So how it works, so basically that is, for example, the database for the foil. That is done with Excel and with Katia. So we define, you have here like plenty of different foil. That is radius, and line. And you can define whatever you've got, like 100 kind of foil. Each time you define a name, you define the folder where you want it. Here, for example, you've got the strut length, the radius strut, radius length, and after, could be quicker. After, we also define on the foil some twist law, some chord law. So everything is parametric. So just with an Excel, you create all the foil you want, all the kind of foil you want, T foil, L foil, C foil, there is no limits. So that is inside our 3D parametrics model, and so it's coupled with the VPP, so it's go, that is a kind of law. And that is the way we generate the geometry after. And it will show TokTok. So each time you create a foil, you want to create a configuration, you create a foil, and you make it. You've got also, you call for a section, and you call for everything. And so that's open automatically Katia. And you design automatically the foil. It's just, you just enter the parameter, you press a button, and you've got your foil, your rudder, and whatever you what you want. So, and after that, so it saves this foil in the global boat, And so we've got the complete boat with the configuration you want. And so it will show it. So, and also with each fold, it creates all the geometry, puts them in a folder, and we get also a quick drawing, a quick description of every geometry we made. So there you've got the foil, the what I was calling the law of twist all along the foil, the chord law, the position of the different section, if we want to have different sections on the foil. And here it's just one section, so you've got here the section with the name of section, and you've got a drawing. So we've got a trace of what everything we did for the design. So, and it is the same for the boat. So everything works like a kind of database where you are, you're looking for the foil, you're looking for everything, for the mast, for the rigging. And it's like you can add whatever you want after. So here it is the same. So you name of project, L, you call for a boat, you call for appendage, you call for a sail plan. And that is a quick example. So here we change you change the beam quickly, you change the foil, you call for another foil. For example, this one's got more close angle, more stability, this one is more open. So that is basically how the 3D parametric part of our tool is working. So the strong point of this part of the tool is that we've got a database. So it's like we can include whatever parameters we want, but each things we learn, or there is new material we want to put in, you can just feed as your project is going in. After, so you've got all the output you want, you've got the area, distance that feed also the VPP, you've got some physical output directly, weight, inertia, you've got a bit of structural calculation inside, and as I said, it's got the link with the VPP input and output. And after, also you can define level of refinement in this model. So I mean, you can just make the basics, and after you can go step further, put the laminates and everything. So it's basically got no limits. It is as far as you want to go. So also we can check the ergonomics. That is the small models of the cat that I will show after. So after, there is the other part, which is the VPP. So here we've got a quick description, basically. So as input, you've got the 3D model or internal optimization that makes the geometry. So that is the VPP model. After, you've got the aero part with the sail model, the wind edge. You've got the hydro part that with the one part is the appendage where you've got lift, viscous drag, induced drag, surface, piercing effect, intersection drag. And you've got the hull with the classical sink, trim, heel, and intersection effect. And you define the condition, the wind and tip of appendage control, which is also important in the case of falling boats, because it is it is an input also that will guide you through the solution. So we've got a 6 DOF solver, and the output is boat speed, fly stability, balance, optimum appendage sail trim, optimum crew position, and etc. So, as we wanted a tool to be very flexible, because at the beginning you want to test everything in an easy way, because as we want a boat that go from the beginner to the more sailing performance, we had to test lots of different configurations. So we had to have a very flexible tool. So the VPP is quite easy to use and quick to test some stuff, some different configuration. And this kind of tool allow you to see quickly what is a key parameter. For example, if you've got an L fold, the angle to close between the tip and the struts in this case is really important. But if you've got a T fold, this is, for example, the wreck will have more importance. So it's allowed to focus on this kind of parameters quickly. And also what I was saying before, what you have to take into account is what freedom you give to your appendix in your platform. So if you give wreck, you will not get the same input to the VPP. If you free can't, it will be a different. So you have to be able to test this kind of stuff quickly to have quick response to what we want, let's say. So that is a typical output of the VPP. So that is a typical L foil configuration with true in speed of 8, 12, and 60 knots. With there, we can see the takeoff and depending on the triangle. So it's just to show what are the outputs. And there, we also we've got the yaw in function of the triangle, and we've got the pitch. So just that shows us the behavior of each configuration, and we can analyze that to choose our best solution. So, but we have to take into account also it's the dynamic part of the, which is very important in the foiling boat, is all the dynamics. So we can analyze in time also the different parameters. So there you can see the boat speed in time. So it takes off, it's got a bit of down, and after it accelerates and gets stable. So you've got the yaw also, you've got the fly height, which gives you a great idea of the stability. And you got also the pitch, which gave you a great idea of the stability. So yeah, so that is just a quick example to show the parametric. So each time we test something, we have directly an output. So you have directly a visualization of what you do. So I don't know if it looks strange, you will see directly that something gets wrong. And for example, there we just change the angle of the between the strut and the tip. So that is about. So as I commented before, we wanted to make a small flying catamaran for two people. So we wanted to be affordable, easy, stable, evolutive, and also we had that we wanted to have that it can be used as a testing platform, because I think a lot of people like to play and would like to play in the garage maybe to. Why not making a new foil, test new configuration, and this kind of stuff? So the idea also is to let it open. So the idea is, so we go for a length of 5.15 meters, beam 255, draft 1.2. For the material, we go to for fiberglass with carbon reinforcement and carbon appendage. So for the sail, we go to simple solution also, main jib. So the idea is to be affordable, is to reduce the cost wherever we can. But in the same time, it has to be strong. And so that is the first configuration. That will be, like we said, the beginner configuration. So it is a normal cat, so straight foil that can go up and down for a beginner, or if you want to sail smoothly, just going out, no foiling. To the configuration one, we call Daggerboard E. So after, we got the configuration two, which is what we call W, which is the idea is to fly, easy flying. So it is a configuration which is a lot more stable, and the idea is not to touch the board and not the span, not the wreck. So the idea is that you use the stability of the chips going up under the water and above the water. So it's, and for example, for this configuration also, we had some wings. It's also like an idea to protect people because you have this foil outside. And that is a configuration two. And we've got a third configuration, which is the classical, like let's say, America's Cup, which is the L foil. So that is when you pass all the steps before, you arrive to this one. And this one will have up and down and rack system. And we call it performance flying. So we make here a little graph to show the affordable of the boat, let's say. So you have the cost in function of the boat speed in like 12 knot speed wind. So let's say we use our tool. So we take our tools and we, for example, the weight change and everything. So, and you've got the configuration. So, for example, so this one is a non-folding. So you will reach certain speed. After, if you go to the folding with the construction we want to be shipped, we will arrive here. But after, you see that the more you to get a bit more speed by making the building process mass more I would say more carbon, more make it more performance, you know. The building and materials and stuff like that. So the gap in the cost is big for a small gap of speed. So we want to build our boat here. So here we've got this graph is also interesting. It shows the stability in function of the different configuration. So here you have an idea of the boat speed and what we call the high stability index, which gives us an index of the stability. So it's the configuration one, which is the one with a straight board, is stable. And after we've got the configuration two, easy flying, which is there, so it is stable. And then the more you go to the L, after you go to the L shape, and you lose stability, but you gain in speed. Okay, so that is just to have some quick graph to show the influence of the different parameters we touch. For example, for the L, you, as I say, it depends where of the angle you put between the struts and the chip, you will be more or less stable. So we want to be stable, but you want to go fast also, as fast as your boats can. So if you go to, so there, in this part you close the V, and this part you open the V. So there you are unstable, and at one point you start to be, you don't gain so much in stability. So we put our target in a place we think for the kind of boat we wanted, we are well. And after, if you get too stable also, it gets hard to fly upwind. So it is like a compromise between both. So what I can say more about this? And also, for sure, the angle depends on the crew skills. If you are, I don't know, if you are quick and you feel it, you can open it more, and it's just more based on your skills. And so another study that was interesting also is the size of the rudder foil, let's say. So if you've got a big elevator, you will have less speed, not so much, but you will get a lot more stable. So you see this one, you've got a faster equilibrium. So this is all these kind of parameters we are playing with and try to put the cursor where we want to be each configuration. I hope it's not too much graph, no? Also, you've got, in this kind of study, you've got also the size of the foil, which is important. So here you've got the boat speed data, and you've got the high stability. So bigger foil, you are more stable. Smaller foil, you are less stable, but you lose in boat speed. In broad reach, if you go upwind, you're looking for more bigger foil. And it's also have an influence of the convergence where your boat will be flying straight. So the idea of the boat also is that as we want cheap, affordable, this is the idea is to use the same set of foils. So we have a little boat, and you use a straight board, you fix the boat, and you fix your, depending on which configuration, you change the T1 to the T2. So you've got the three configuration with a set of foils, let's say. So as we wanted a testing platform, as you see that you've got this configuration and this configuration, so you've got like a hole for the bearing and the different configuration. So it can be also a testing platform. This is the way we thought about it. And so the future of this project is now we've got more or less nearly all the number. So we need a bit of refined design, and we will start the prototype very soon. And after that, if it's up, everything going well, we will start also the production. And this project allows us also to create these tools that make possible now to apply to any boat. We can use a bigger boat, and after you just feed your in-house tool to fit your project. And that's it. Thank you. Okay.
Thanks, Mark.
Thank you.
Fabulous. Any questions, queries? I'm sure there must be a few from the floor.
Yeah. It depends on the configuration, but as we are at 150 for the 150, yeah. We are still on that. We are asking for price now and try to push everything down. We've got still a bit of structure to calculate, and we've got a bit of that to do still. That is a bit of.
Did you start with the design across the board?
Yeah, but we are half of the. We're missing data, I think. But yeah, we have a target. I cannot say a price, but an E class would be to reach a price enough in an E class would be. Really quite good, and if we can go less, it would be even better. But
do you have a timeline on the?
No, we will soon start the prototype. We are looking for where to build it, mm-hmm. and it should start in months. Let's say the prototype, and after we have a small period of tests, and after let's see if it's going well, if we have some refinement to do or stuff like that, and up to start the production as soon as we can.
Okay.
Sure.
Okay.
Why do you need to do a new hull? Why don't you just take something that's already there and attach different appendages to?
To make the test, you said?
Yeah.
No, that's
16, Formula 18, whatever takes your fancy.
Yeah. Yeah, but that can be. We can also use the prototype because that is a finite hull, let's say. So if we make the mold on everything already, we will have this after. So
just putting the cost up so much.
Yeah, but it is something that we will have done after. So you will. Well, quite confident in what we will test. So I think we will not mess because basically the shape of the hull is fixed. So it works also as a small catamaran. So we are pretty confident in the hull, and we'll build this hull. We'll make the catamaran. This so can be an idea. Yeah, I understand your point, but we'll make a bit of garage work. And
sorry. The ring. Carbon or?
No, for the moment we go for aluminium, but. We have also to compare some price, and we have still some area where we're not really sure what is. We are missing a couple of price and, to compare them.
How much does the prototype weigh?
It will weigh like 150, as I said before. So it will be a scale prototype, so it will. Will more or less weigh the same as I suppose a bit more because but yeah, should be around this weight.
Thank you.
150, you said?
Yeah.
Yeah. 150.
Sorry, 150. Yeah.
Well, you said two adults. What weight vessel? What weight
of the sailors?
The idea is to make it quite open. So we want to, as it can be, let's say, we want it also to be a bit of a family catamaran. We want that to, because I'm not very fit, so I want to I want to be able to bring a friend of mine, which looks like me. So the range of weight, we put some volume in the hull, and the foil will be our calculate to lift some good little boys.